make sure we're live as general. And I suck at doing Twitch stuff. But let us see. So we got. Okay, there we go. I can see myself. Let me just get the chat on a second screen. No, that's the wrong button. Okay, this is pop out. Go here. You go here. Okay, fine. That's not live. Come on, stats. Oh, there we go. Okay, now that works. Works. Let me just here. Good. Fine, that looks fine. And green. There we go. Okay, that looks good. I think we can start. Yeah, okay. Looks fine, right? Yeah, we're good. Cool. Let's do this. All right. Hi, everyone. How's it going? Team here. And this is first and hopefully one of many upcoming live streams of exploring the different frameworks, languages, libraries, whatever you can imagine. And, you know, since we finished the building data science with JavaScript course, I want to do something shorter because they fall off in terms of people watching my stuff in the beginning to the end is very large, as I already like. We talked about that in Discord a bit, but the thing is that basically out of, if we take the data science course, which was the least popular one, there was 500 to 600 views on the first video, basically, and it dropped down all the way to the 80 on the next to the second one. So I haven't seen the views on the last one because I just published it today, so we have to wait a bit. But basically, I'm expecting to see like 50, maybe 60, and you know, that's like 10 times drop, which makes me extremely sad. So after some thinking, I thought, like, okay, let's do some one-off or, you know, very short series that will have like one or two episodes, and then just basically go with what you guys want, just to see, you know, what kind of languages do you want to see, what kind of frameworks do you want me to get covered, and so on and so forth. So today we're going to be, since, you know, the React Native was the most wanted topic after the data science, actually, I thought, sure, let's do a pretty, you know, like in-depth introduction to React Native to sort of show you all you have to know about React Native to actually get going. And let's try that. So I did work on React Native quite some time ago. It's been quite a while, so I know that it's evolved significantly. So I have no idea how it works right now. I mean, I'm guessing the basics haven't really changed much, but I imagine there is a significant number of simplifying things, maybe some adjustments, some changes, maybe some improvements. So basically, I'm coming in here without knowing too much about it. I do have a background in mobile development, and I've built several products from scratch using web technologies for mobiles and using hybrid technologies and as well native technologies. So they include like stuff like Xamarin, stuff like PhoneGap, which is now Cordova, I believe. Stuff like just pure Objective-C and so on and so forth. So we're gonna, you know, have a look at React Native and see how that goes. I guess let us get started, right? I imagine we would need increase the size of that. I imagine we would need what do you call it? The Android SDK, for example, if I want to build for Android, right? Okay, npm install -g create React Native app. NPX still a thing, right? Hey, I guess we could do that. So I just move this exploring RN a little quieter so that we don't hear all the blips. And we can do NPX, create reading nap, exploring RN. Okay, let's see if NPX works as expected, because I don't really want to install create React Native app. Yeah, that seems to be working. Hopefully it cleans it up properly. Okay, so as you would expect, basically to run the app and to properly develop, you would need SDKs from all the platforms that you are actually using. So if you're, say, using iOS, you would need Xcode. If you are using Android, you would need Android SDK. Obviously, with Android, it's quite simple. With iOS, I haven't actually... I've heard they've changed stuff, but you no longer actually need Mac to develop for it. But yeah, let's see. Okay, so after running it, what do we have? We have yarn start to start development server, yarn run iOS to run iOS, Mac only required. Okay, so you still require Xcode. I guess there are some workarounds that, but okay, I think I had Android tools installed, right? Android update SDK, let us maybe run an update. Android is Gigamaster, say blah, blah, blah. By setting US SDK wrapper, wait, what was it? It was a command to update the run this Android UI thing. Use wrapper, blah, blah, blah. Okay, type Android. I don't remember which is local bin Android. Was that that's like a public link? Yeah, okay. Oh, so it's a cask thing, okay. We go here and I guess they changed the API. Okay, yes, that export. Okay, so we do yarns. First of all, we have to actually open that code. So it actually, but I guess because I recreated a folder, code just went nuts. Hey, yours truly. How's it going? So we just started. Feel free, as usual, you know, feel free to ask questions. My VS Code is doing something. What? I think I broke it. As usual, feel free to ask questions. Feel free to, you know, stop me at any moment and ask what's going on. Okay, so I assume we need to do a yarn start. This will package everything and start a development server, which I think React Native also supports hot reload, which is actually amazing for mobile development. Yarn run iOS, I believe. Let's start the iOS thing. Looks like we're gonna see at the time. Press A to open Android emulator. Press I. Oh, you can even do that from. Okay, wait. We can kill that. So, and just say I, right? Oh, nice. Okay, so they now have an interactive command line interface where you can just start everything from the same dev server, which is kind of cool. Oh, my computer is not happy about running all that. All right, let's see. Okay, that is okay, now here we go. Oh, yeah, I guess it's taking so long because I haven't actually started the new emulator once. So it's been so long since I developed anything for mobiles that I probably after the last Xcode update, I haven't even started the thing. So that's probably why it's taking so much time. So where's my thing? I have to redo that now. Yeah, I guess I do. I guess uninitialized emulator is not something React Native knows how to work with. Hi, Renato. How's it going? All right, let's try this again. So now it should be better, right? Yeah, open. There we go. Okay, so we got our Expo app. And now it's going to bundle everything. I guess so it looks like it's doing the whole thing dynamically when you're developing. Oh, it now has a nice status too. Nice. A lot of JavaScript stuff in there. I imagine since the time when I was first working with React Native, they've added a lot of more JavaScript wrappers around the native API because, you know, it's a sane thing to do, basically. Nice. Okay. So this is Control D to show this menu. Okay. Ah. Oh, whoa. So they have a development menu now, which you can call using the command D. Right, refresh, copy link, go to Expo Home, reload, disable live rail, show performance monitor. That is really cool. Hot reloading unavailable. Why? Can't use live reload or hot reloading at the same time. Ah, okay, I see. Toggle element inspector and debug remote.js. Fine. Okay, so this is our app. And, this is tests, and the app itself is, I guess, here, right? Okay, why is there so many errors? Yes, stateless, no. Thank you very much. Format that. Okay, so theoretically, if we remove that, we should see the change on the screen. Nice. Okay, seems to be working perfectly fine. Yeah, there is a specific style sheets that you need to write, so this is still the same. Like, you cannot use the normal CSS, but there's basically wrappers around that. Okay, React Native, what can we do? React Native UI library, right? So this is what I'm interested in because I want to invent my own UI. Components, native base, short-term UI kit. There is so many now. Okay. I guess UI kit, UI kitten. Yeah, that, wait, I just want to search for that because what the, there's an actual, yeah, okay. I mean, JavaScript world is, and the joke about typing JavaScript spacebar, any random word will get your library, still holds true. Okay. What do we have here? Native base kitchen sink demo. Yes. Let us please have a look at demo. Okay, scan QR, request the link. I guess this will just give us the, yeah, so this is a pre-built demo. Is there a, oh, there we go. There's some GIFs. That looks not bad at all. Okay, I wonder how the default component looked. Okay, so what do we want to make with the app? I guess it would be nice to try. Hi, Wise, how's it going? I guess it would be nice to try, I guess, load something and then display it in a list, maybe something like this, and then show, like, okay, you know what? The best app to do ever is Hacker News, right? So we're gonna go to newswirecombinator.com. First of all, JS, Hacker News. I mean, there gotta be a JavaScript Hacker News API, right? Or a library that wraps around it, because I don't want to invent that myself. I'm sure there's so many of them that, okay, this is, seems to be a Node.js thing. By the way, the React Native is not Node.js. Oh, you have a lunch break there now. Okay, that's quite some time difference. Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's see. What does this do? I mean, if you know any good wrappers, then please do let me know in the chat. I will, like, they will save us a lot of time. Okay, so this is actually XML HTTP requests, maybe this one, and documentation and samples for, oh wait, they have official one. Okay, right, Hacker News API, Hacker News more efficient method of calling, blah blah blah. Okay, when, you know what, we can just go to yarn package, say Hacker News, right? Hacker News scraping for not. Why would you want to scrape if they have API, right? Well, this is official API, right? Yeah, this looks like official API to me. Okay. I mean, let's try this one. Why not? So I'm going to stop that. I'm going to say yarn at Hacker News API. 6 hours behind. Wow. Okay. Well, so which country, which place are you from? Which city? I'm kind of curious. It's gotta be a US something, right? Probably. All right, okay, let's see. We added that. So let us get to try and load that. So we got import syntax from Hacker News and structure super. We don't care about props right now. This state is gonna be posts empty. And then component did, so I think the component's lifecycle is slightly different from the React. Close enough to US, Canada. Oh man, Canada. So I've been looking into Canada lately, and it looks like an amazing country. And I definitely want to go visit sometime, at least, you know, Toronto and all this kind of like really big cities that look like a lot of fun. And I don't know, I've been lately thinking maybe I should find a work there and just move to Canada, because it, honestly, it looks like my kind of place. Right, let's do did mount, and gonna do hn get item. Is there a get feed? Get new stories, 500 stories, 200, get, no, ask show top stories. Let's go with the top stories for now. Okay, in, it is a sync, I imagine. A sync, what? What? Oh, that's confusing. I imagine it takes a callback, right? Return HTTP get. Stop it. HTTP get is the wrapper URL. I don't think that's how HTTP works. Right, those API, this package is, this literally here won't work, right? Because it's an asynchronous request. So if you're very lucky and your internet is very fast, this will be parsed and you will actually get the result. But if not, then you won't really get anything. Oh dear, okay. Grapes, Hacker News, okay, let's try Hacker News API maybe. So yeah, this is the one that is not working. Hacker News API client, 2 years ago, two months ago. Node.js library for Algolia Hacker News API. Okay, let us have a look at that. It's also, yeah, if you yeah, I definitely will let you guys know if I travel somewhere. I mean, that doesn't happen as often as it used to happen when I was like doing my PhD and going for all the conferences around the world. But sure, I will absolutely know, let the people know. Yeah, Renata, I saw the official API, but this is just a doc, right? So it doesn't actually let you code anything. Thing speaks is JavaScript and light. Yeah, I mean, mostly JavaScript, but you know. CSGO online based website, Twitter. Okay, I mean, sure, but that sounds like gambling to me. I don't like gambling. Please don't do that. Okay, where's the, there we go, there's the GitHub thing. Okay, let us have a look at this one. Okay, that looks like this callback base. Does it have promises? That would be so nice. What does it return? Like as always, I mean, it's kind of interesting that, you know, 90% of the time to figure out how the API works, you have to go into the source code and look. Okay, so we got, okay, so it's callback based. I mean, it's not a bad option. Use API client 6 months ago, 10 months ago. Firebase Hacker News 5 months ago. That doesn't sound too bad. Okay, 3 years ago, that's definitely too long. Okay, let's see, what do you do? You also have callbacks, but I mean, I guess we can use, I know we can't use Promisify, it's a node thing, right? Not a gambling site, very unique. Okay, Algolia, I mean, I'm sure Algolia has way more than Elasticsearch behind them because they do some crazy stuff. Elasticsearch on its own is a very simple thing, right? It's like a database that provides a full text search. You just throw in your stuff and then you can execute pretty complex search queries, which is actually, you know what? I have to write that down. So because Elasticsearch sounds like a really cool topic to talk about on the channel, because I've been using it for the past like 3 or 4 years and it's an amazing tool. So it would be pretty fun to explore it. Okay, we got this one. Let's have a look. So a node HN API, HN PVA API. Right, and there is no, for some reason there is no, okay, I guess this is for the more for the browsers, but there is no GitHub. It's, oh, there is GitHub, but it's not linked in the, I guess it's not linked in the package itself. Firebase HN API. And we have promises. Yeah, there we go. This works with promises, so we can use that. I love promises. I love async await, and I, you know, no freaking way I'm going back to callbacks. Okay, let me just turn the chat a bit to my side so that I can actually see what's going on. Okay, let's see the depth. So if it doesn't use any node specific stuff, that won't work in dependency Firebase. Now here's the question, does the Firebase API work within React Native? Let's find out, I guess. Yarn adds. Okay, you know what I'm gonna do? I've just installed this dictionary, Google dictionary, that I'm using for German to learn like better German basically. And it's a bit annoying that it pops up on everything. There we go, much better. Okay, yarn start. Where's the usage? Okay, yeah, I guess that's gonna break, right? It's not gonna work because I import the stuff that's no longer in the thing. Firebase database. Okay, there we go. Initializing with Firebase. Okay, huh. I guess, wait, but I then need to install Firebase as well, or is it direct dependency? try that. Okay. Import. Import. There we go. From. Okay. From Firebase Hacker News, and we create the service. Okay. Start a user then. Initialize stories top then, and there we go. Okay, so this is what we do. Okay, const, oh, I guess that state is gonna be posts, right? So we have this post stories top. No, that's not gonna work because I'm an idiot. Const posts, we're gonna await that, and then it's gonna be posts, and we're done, right? Sync. Theoretically, yeah, it's gonna complain that when I don't set state in this set state, don't set state in component. The posts are not used, and for now I'm just gonna do this. I guess there's no JSON stringify here, right? It's posts. Let's do this to actually just make sure that it's actually working. Can I please have it in iOS? Thank you very much. Oh, it is in iOS already. Okay, this post length is undefined. Yes, we have to kill it first. Command R reload JS. Oh man, okay. I've been writing so much Vue.js lately that I forgot how things work. Unhandled promise rejection. Can't find variable performance? Wait, okay, I guess this does work. When I was trying to work with querying Firebase and another, Firebase doesn't go, but you Elasticsearch. Okay, let me read that comment properly. I looked into it some time ago when I was trying to work with querying Firebase and found out that Firebase doesn't do that. But you can use Elasticsearch to query, but I couldn't figure out how to make it work. So maybe you could. Okay, yeah, I think Elasticsearch video is a great idea. I mean, it's not extremely complicated tool. There are some quirks here and there. But I'm sure we can figure it out. Okay, let's see. React Native, Hacker News, library. Okay, let's see. Maybe Hacker News, React Native. Okay, we have another React Native thing. So let's see, what do they use? Don't tell me they wrote everything themselves. Looks like they literally did. Makes me a bit sad. But I mean, the worst case, we can do the same. So, News JavaScript library, please tell me there is something. Yeah, no, that's not what I want. React and React powered Hacker News clients. You know what? Screw that. We're just gonna use the API directly. Okay, let's see. React Native HTTP request. So here's what I'm curious about. Last time I used some nodes, I think there was they were planning to add. Okay, they just added fetch. Cool. Before I had to use some libraries, far as I remember. But once again, I've tried React Native when it was like 0.1 or something, when they just released it basically. Okay. Blah blah blah. So stories, comments, jobs. So what we want is this is items design, URL and versioning. So okay, this is the URL we want. Okay, through that, we're gonna go bare bones basically, right? So const base URL, okay. Item, no, we don't need items. Can we get please users, live data, sample, okay. So we get copy link, okay. Const top stories. Gonna be, we don't need print pretty, right? So we need the base URL. Yes, we're gonna remove the trailing slash here, and it's gonna be base URL. That, right? So this is gonna be top stories, and this is what we wanna get first. Fetch top stories, then r.json. Yeah, and then let's do console log posts just to see. So I assume that should be an array of stuff, right? Yeah, okay, so we get an array. Whoa, okay, that is a lot. Let's go with top 20. Top posts. Sorry, okay, I guess there's gonna be top posts and top post slice, let's call it this way. We're going to be top posts slice A20, yes. And then we need to map them all. So it's going to be await promise all. So we're going to wait for all promises, and we're going to top post slice. We're going to map it and map the post into fetch, which is going to be base URL, right? And it's going to be slash, and then we need the item thing. Item, so it's going to be slash item, and I guess it's going to be key. So this is our item ID, I guess. This is more explicit, right? Okay, console log posts. Let's see if that works. Did I actually get the correct thing? So, I mean, that looks like, so this is for items, and then they have a separate endpoint for users. Okay. Let's see if that works. Oh, it's already executed it. Okay, cool. That is a ton of... Wait, why is there Google Analytics inside of it? What is going on in this stuff? Did I query the wrong thing? Okay. Let me try to reload it and see what's going on. That doesn't seem to be correct. Oh, right. Okay, wait a second. No, that's correct, right? Unless I am screwing something up. Wait a second. Top post slice. Okay, so we have a bunch of numbers, right? So those numbers are, I guess, posts as per API. New top and best story. Yeah, top story is JSON. That's what we get. Okay. We need to take this number and I assume max item, I assume we throw it into the API, right? Oh, it's .json. Okay, that's the problem. So this is .json and then posts. Now we should actually see, I guess I would have to actually resolve JSON. No, that's the, so we then, yeah, we then have to say then our JSON, right? So we have to get the body there. And now there we go. Okay, so now we actually have objects that have titles, usernames and stuff like this. Okay, now we got this bit working. I guess first let's try to do this with without any UI libraries. Let's see, guides IS. Okay, where's our components? There we go. So we want a list. Section list. Is section list what we want? Is there a screenshot somewhere? No. Perform a list. Okay. We don't need sections. Something simpler. Just need props. We need just a simple list. App state, async. There's just a scroll view, I guess, right? Okay, wait, those seem to be, those are API. Wrong thing. Scroll view, list. Oh, list view, okay. Yes, this is what we want. So, right. So we get this and we throw in this thing. Yes, we can actually kill the whole damn thing here, right? Because we don't really need other stuff around it. It's going to be posts. Say this set states posts render data, and to render the data, okay, so what do we have here? This is a very simple example, but we need to render it. I mean, okay, let's start with a simple example, right? So it's gonna be p, and we're gonna render p, what was it, title, right? Format that, there we go. I had that problem with pull request that I was submitting, and I had to turn off the format on save thing because it was messing things up. There we go, much better. But I guess we need to import list view from React Native. There we go. Okay. Undefined is not an object, all row it is length. Hey, is there a specific data format it should follow? Row has changed. Oh, it's a list view data source. Here's one of the things about React Native and mobile development, right? If you don't know the basics of mobile development, you will have problems understanding some of the things that going on in React code. So for example, here we're looking at the list view, and you cannot just pass a bunch of items to it, because then you the list view won't be able to update properly. So the way that list views work on mobiles is that you don't render, like if you pass the list 200 items or even like 20, the Android or iOS won't render all of them. They will only render whatever is visible on the screen, right? And there is a special update functions that basically figure out which row should be rendered and which is not, which should be utilized, which should be moved to the end and then re-rendered with new data and so on and so forth. So this is why we have to create this data source. And I guess in this case we say that DS clone with rows, and then we give this array of posts, right? So I guess this is this. Okay, so first of all we're gonna do this, so it doesn't need to be in a state, but it's gonna be in a component. It's gonna be this DS, yes, and then basically because it needs to be rows, which is going to make it empty, right? DS, okay. And this should be posts, obviously, right? There's too many. First, there we go. Okay, now let's see if that works. And next, action headers will be rendered and enable empty sections. We don't have any sections. Why are you telling me this? Failed prop validation, data source of type array supplied to expected. No, I just changed that. Okay, let's try to rebuild that. Maybe it didn't pick up my changes, but it should have, right? Either I'm doing something wrong or probably I'm doing something wrong. That's how it usually is. So that was all about list view, because you know the list views don't, as I said, don't render the whole list at once. It's very similar to how the, what was the name of that thing, React Virtualized, I think it was. Yeah, so there's this really cool library for browsers called React Virtualized, and it basically does what the mobile devices do to the data. So it only renders the elements that user can actually see on a screen and then throws anything else away, which saves you a lot of memory, which is, you know, quite important in the mobile world. Oh no, it actually renders it, but we got some warnings. Okay, reload that, and what are the warnings again? Can I please? There we go. Next release, empty section headers will be rendered. In this release, you can use enable empty sections flag to render empty section headers. Okay, let's see what is this empty section flags. And it is, okay, whether empty, yeah, it should be so. I guess we just say equals false. Is that what you want? Next release will be deprecate. Really? Okay, I mean, I don't really have any sections. What do you want from me? This is slightly confusing. Okay, warning, in next release, let's see. Okay, so you said you can use empty flag to, yeah, but I, okay, so what do I do to fix that? Tell me. This flag reference ignition list view. Okay, I guess. Oh, it wants me to set it to true, not false. Okay. Huh? Okay, now it works. Can I just comment on iPhone X display fading? Like, why? Why would you? Oh my god. Okay. So we got here, right? Yeah, because iPhone, we have to actually do something. We need to add the, I guess, how do you call that? probably is toolbar or something, right? Toolbar Android view. Status bar, maybe? No. Status bar is probably same as the props, merge navigator, imperative API. So, I mean, status bar is what you have on. Status bar is what you have here, right? So, this is not what we want. Maybe just start padding, which sounds ridiculously stupid, but. List, switch, slider. I mean, I guess we can just add another view here, right? So, it can be view. Then we can just say style styles container, whatever. So we can say that, say 80 or something. That work? Okay, there we go. Okay, 80 maybe is a bit too much. This one doesn't seem to be. So let's do posts flex one. Yes, we need to say that it's going to be styles post, right? We want that post to be stretched to the whole thing. Come on, my app. Did I screw it up? What was it? Command D. Element inspector, tap something to inspect it. This is view, okay, this is not what I want, right? What? Inspect. Okay, desktop, whoops, what? Oh, you can actually go to JavaScript from there, okay. I think there was a way to change the zoom of this physical size. Can I please get device bezels and zoom? Okay, now I can zoom. There we go. Okay, that looks much nicer. At least I can read what's going on the screen now. Header bar. I mean, there's the toolbar in the. Okay, let me check this issue that the chat sent. Support iPhone X. Okay, so this is a specific problem with, I mean, I've this bezel thing or bevel thing, whatever you call it, on our iPhone X is so screwed up. This basically most of the technologies now have to support it. Either you like support it properly or you do it manually, right? I guess the stupid way is to just add a view in there and like manually adjust to it, which is like, oh, come on. Okay, field flex one, awaken dev app root components. I guess I screwed something up. See, that is wrong. 800, is that better? No. Okay, it actually did. Can I close that thing somehow? Oh, okay, so why doesn't it flex to the whole? Oh, I guess because styles main, right? So because we need the main view to also flex to the whole thing, okay. One thing I could tell is that using flexbox to, I please, I, yeah, there we go. So one thing is that using flexbox to actually render the whole React Native or the whole UI is much more pleasant than using both Android and iOS tools, at least it was as they were 3 years ago. I guess they are way more advanced right now, but that is still, like, you know, kind of painful. Okay, so we need a row renderer. I guess for that we could just make another component, right? So we can just do it inline. Post extends act components. I guess we don't actually need the whole thing, right? We can just do an arrow function in this case. So this is gonna be view. In this case, we're gonna have text, which is gonna be our. Copy that bit. mean, I guess we can just, much nicer. This is gonna be post. There you go. Or rather, that's gonna be post title. I need double destruction because we give post as a property. Post is missing prop validation. Yeah, I don't care about prop validation right now, but in theory, load that just to make sure that actually works. Cool. So we now have this list. Let me have a look at the chat quick. There was something at the very bottom. As of 7 days, there was a comment left on that saying that React Native 050 will automatically detect iPhone X. Nice. Okay. I mean, you know, since we're not doing a production ready thing, that's it's fine. I mean, I think 80 pixels offset from top is okay for this case because we're just developing on this thing and whatever. I guess it's really nice that they actually went ahead and made it so that it auto detects it and, you know, auto sets the whole thing. Flexbox, yes, Flexbox is indeed amazing because making UIs without it is a huge pain, especially when you need to scale something. Right, okay, so let's see, style, let's say styles post. In this case is going to be post, it's going to say height, say 80 pixels. It's going to make them a bit bigger, right? Yeah, there you go, okay. Now I actually have a scrolling list, and as I was saying, so once we scroll past the item, it gets de-rendered and basically reused to render the next item that is coming down there, which is like why we are able to have those huge infinite lists on mobile devices. Okay, so what kind of data we have from that, from the post there? Let me see, so we can say log posts. Maybe we can make a bit nicer UI to add like a user or something. Okay, so we have time, we have title, we have URL, I guess. I mean, in this case, it doesn't matter. And we got score. We have a username by is. Okay, so we have this by thing. So we got that. I guess we could render. It's gonna be by, and we're gonna be score. It's gonna be by. I guess. I mean, can you do inline styling here? Just say font. Yeah, okay, you can. So say this is font size. Try. So let's see if we make this a bit bigger, like 16. I don't know what's the size, what's the default size. Make this like 13. Then we do score here and we make it 13 and we make it font weight. Oh, it's been something wonky going on with my VS Code lately. It suggests a lot of things that are should not be there. Maybe the other way around. Okay, so that will be like three lines, right? Yeah. So it would be nice to say, keep the user there, but put the score on the failed prop validation. Yeah, okay, you start off with your prop validation for now. I guess we just say this is gonna be view, right? So it's basically, you are doing everything with views here. So say style, this is gonna be flex direction column, right? You say that this should be flex one, so it should take the whole thing, and then the score should be on the right if I didn't screw this up. And of course I did. Should it be a row? Am I messing things up? I always confuse those two. There we go. Okay. Now we need some padding. It's kind of amazing that you can build mobile UIs using CSS, essentially, you know. I remember how much pain we had aligning the designs that the designers brought to us to the actual user interface. And that was so bad. Okay, that looks better. I mean, obviously, you know, I'm not a designer, and this is kind of not particularly good, let's put it this way. Okay, let's do this a bit, padding top 10 maybe, so that is sort of separated a bit. Okay, this is slightly better. What can we do? We can say maybe font size larger so that titles are slightly better, right? Slightly more recognizable. There we go. That looks much better. Let's try 20 here and then maybe 14 so that it doesn't go to like a pixel bollocks. Okay, yeah, that looks better. Again, you know, on an actual device that will look completely different because of the way it renders there. Okay, is there no, I guess, is there a React Native package? Wait a second. React Native. There has to be a React Native package, right? React Native tools, code hinting. There we go. Why I love modern web development and modern editors, because you can literally install everything you need with like one click. Okay, there we go. We have that. So now can I get suggestions to my... Come on. No, still no suggestion, really. How is that? My code completion, I just want to stop. Okay, border bottom color. Okay. You know what? I'm going to move that. I'm going to develop this inline because I want my completion, because I have no idea what properties I can use here. And we're going to move it out to the style sheet later on. Black. That work? Nope. Yes, that's not enough. Okay. React Native Border, view border, I guess. Yes, this was a React Native CLI. So basically I went to the getting started guides and executed. I mean, it says npm install minus g, but what I did was, it's by the way, it's not CLI anymore. It's create React Native app now. So it's a fork of create React app for React Native, which I think it does a pretty nice job. And you can run both iOS and Android stuff from there. So I just run npx, x, there you go. This is what I ran, and that worked perfectly fine. Okay, and now I forgot what I wanted to do. All right, I wanted to see how to do a border properly. Speed view, how to create text border, border radius, border color doesn't work. Oh yeah, I completely forgot about this thing. There is an amazing online playground. So, oh, they closed it. Oh no, it was so good. All right. So there was a really cool tool that allowed you to literally code React Native apps on the web. So you could just go there and you will see the preview on the right with the phone, and then you can just do things on the left. Okay, I guess you can do the same now here, but it shows it. Oh, there's a preview. Okay, yeah, so there you go. If you want to play, you don't even need to set up anything. You can just do it in the web, which is, in my opinion, amazing. And probably blocking everything here, yeah. Let's do this, reload this page. Pretty much, I don't want to run it on my platform. I just want to see the preview here. And there we go, a bunch of other stuff. I make this go, reload, and there's our work now. And there we go. Cool. Tap to play. No, I don't want to just show me the app. Let's be logged in. Appetize account. Ah, okay. So I guess they monetized it basically. No, wait, does it work or not? I am confused. It actually seems to be working. Anyway, there's a bunch of pretty cool web tools that allow you to run this stuff on directly on web. You can toggle the SDK versions, Androids, iOS versions, and so on and so forth. So what do we have here? Changing code editor, blah blah blah. So theoretically, if we delete some stuff here, we should actually see that happening there. There you go. That's actually pretty neat. So it's now just called differently, basically, but allows you to do the thing. Okay, let's see. How did they do the border? Border style solid, border left width, top width. Okay, I guess. Yeah, let's try. Border bottom width. One, like thin border at the bottom just to separate. That's not thin. Okay, can I do 0.1? Does it allow floats? That's too thin. Right. Let's try to find the correct value here. That's too thick. Ooh. Kind of doesn't seem to be even step. Yeah, there we go. Okay, that's slightly better, but let's try. See? A bit weird. I wonder if it's... I guess it's because of this scaling... actually scale. Yeah, I guess it's because of the scaling that the screen is all screwed up here. Physical size, pixel accurate. You cannot show pixel accurate on this screen because it doesn't even fit on it, basically, right? Which is a bit sad, but okay. Okay, so we got kind of divided list. Now we need to make it clickable and then have another page where we would load the what do you call it, the full text or comments or whatever, right? Okay, now how do you do routing here? This is something I have not done in a long time. Okay, status bar, handling touches. Yeah, let's do handling touches first. On press, that is as simple as it gets, basically. Okay, now how do you do React Native routing? Okay, screw the elements for now. We just want something. Routing and router flex. There a default router. Doesn't seem so. Okay, native UI, native modules, contributing. List view, model, yeah, okay. Scary? No, it's not scary. I mean, come on. Mobile devices had amazing routers from the get-go. This is like one part that was definitely implemented great. Okay, this is Android toolbar. Is there no router for it, really? Navigator. Is that what we want? Navigator thing? Navigating between scenes. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so it's just not called routing, it's called navigator. Stack navigator. Okay, yes, stack navigator is that thing with stuff on the bottom, right? Can I... Navigator iOS. Or maybe not. Okay, let's try Stack Navigator. We get a Stack Navigator. And yes, app. Okay, so this is gonna be, let's call it homepage. Then we're not gonna export that. We're gonna export default class and React components, right? And render, thank you very much. Gonna return Stack Navigator, which will have home, which is gonna be home page. And that's it for now. That work? No, it doesn't work. So what am I doing here wrong? Then you can quickly, so. Oh, okay, so it is a separate, okay. I completely missed that step. Oh, and it is from React, okay. So that's not a core thing. Right, I'm being an idiot as usual. Okay, let's see, import that from React Navigation, there we go. Okay, yarn start. All right, let's see, come on. My computer is starting to try to take off, but I guess that's expected. Yes, there you go. I'll reload that. And are we working? Functions are not valid as React child. Okay. Functions are not, but it worked before. Yes, I guess the app itself. So basically, this is exactly the syntax that they shown should be like this, right? So it should be this. Whoops, no, that should be right, right? App for default app, yes. Okay, it seems like a huge thing on top. I guess this is our view that we the padding thing, right? Yeah, so we can kill that, which, because it looks like this navigator takes handle of it on its own, which is nice. And we'll get some background. You failed props. Yeah, okay, I don't care about props. Okay, and then basically on post click, which is here, we say on touch, right? Not on touch, on touch, start, on touch, end, I guess. Or on press would be a better on press. No. It doesn't allow to do on press on views. So on touch end, navigate. Where do we get the navigate? Okay, this props navigation. Aha. Okay, so this is part. Okay, now basically we have to pass it through the props function that will take post, and then yes, this post is nav to post, means that we have to add nav to post and props navigation, yes, and we all navigate and then profile, and then we set the data. So this is going to be post, and then it's going to be post. In this case, we have to say if we're going to have a post screen which has a post page, and we need to make this post page. The app is getting slightly complicated, but yeah, I think we should handle that. So for now, I'm going to kill all of that. We don't need that anymore. I'm gonna kill this. Let's say post, which is gonna be empty. This. This is gonna be post page, and it's gonna be main. And this is gonna be text. This. No, it's not the props, right? It's going to pass it as something different. How do you get pass props? No, this is iOS thing. So, okay, we want to see the React Navigation Getting Started guide. That sounds like a good thing. Once again, if you have any questions or are confused by some things that I'm doing, feel free to ask in the chat. I'm sometimes looking there at it. And yeah, okay. Detail screen, yeah, okay, yeah. How do you pass stuff? Oh, and then here you can have a title. Well, that would be really nice. Don't you format my code anymore? Props, is that why you don't format my? No, I think formatting broke. I don't know why, but prettier has been like breaking for me occasionally, like it's at least inside of the VS Code, it's like just randomly stops working. I'm not sure why. The button to reload everything wasn't there. Whatever. Works for now, it's fine. Okay. React Native, okay, home screen. Navigate, yeah. How do you pass in property? Navigate. Oh, okay, this guy doesn't have it. Simple app. No, simple app is boring. Navigation plan. Okay, navigator, stack navigator. Where's the router's view? Okay, come on, where's the API? This is docs, right? Stack tab action navigation prop. Is that what we want? Navigate. Okay, it looks like this navigate and there's state. Okay, screen current state root. I guess is it in a state? Log. So we want to take that navigation and state, and we're gonna say state here. So theoretically, when I switch it, obviously, hello, do that. JSX is really assigned to a non-empty expression. That coming from? I screw up this time around. Failed. Font key supplied. This should not be a problem, right? No, AppJS6 on line 10. Okay. What did I do? Oh, goddamn, I'm an idiot. I completely forgot about that. All right, there we go. There's our home. And if I forgot to do the tapping. So we got, we pass the navigate function. And here on touch end, we just say navigate to post, right? Yes, then we cannot really use destruction because we need the whole post thing. So we have to adjust that a bit. Post score, post by, right? Go bundle rebuild, reload that, and theoretically now if we tap that, we go here. And what do you not like? There is some build prop. Okay, this is prop validation again. Yes, it doesn't want font. Oh, is that why it's failing? It wants the font size here. No longer fail. Okay, so the font size was actually taking effect because I'm an idiot, right? Okay, maybe we do it as a min height 100 because they don't seem to scale otherwise. But on touch end now works as a basically whenever you scroll drag it will also be like this. Component will I made it a sync because I just wanna await the fetch here. That's basically it. So I mean you don't have to make it a sync, you can make it sync. And I mean theoretically, you know, you don't want to do this in component did mount, it should be done somewhere in the store. But because we're hacking this up and just looking how the React Native works, I thought, you know, what the hell, I'll just make it a sync and fetch everything here. This is not exactly the pattern you should be using. Okay, so on touch end, okay, let's see, React Native view on press. Is there on press for view? Yeah, it's obviously it doesn't work. Touchable opacity. Okay, touchable without, okay, though there is some touchable thing. Let's see, touchable highlight, touchable opacity. Okay, so we have to wrap our view in this. Okay, that's touchable opacity. They actually added a wrapper that you can use to simplify touching. That's kind of handy. That and go. Okay, so now if we scroll it, it should just scroll. It even makes it a pack, like a button. Amazing. It works. Yay. And we got, I assume that's actually the list of post. No. Actually doesn't actually component will update. Yes, we have to check the next props, right? Props. Okay, let's try that. I am not sure it actually renders. Oh, you know what? We can remove the console log from here because we know it works and it just pollutes the whole log thing. Okay, we got that. And there is no log here. Why? I don't know why, but okay. Updated. Let's see. What if we just have a look at next props here? That never triggers. Okay. Let's see. Oh, I am curious. Okay. So basically, this props. This props, right? That work. Okay, this way it works. Ah, there we go. Okay, so it actually gets the navigation and we get the state, and the state contains our, wait, it says updated now. What the, does the bundle update this long? Okay. Right, okay, so we're gonna make this a sync again because I'm lazy, and we are gonna say, we're getting the whole, like the post itself, but we don't get actually any an API. We don't get any, what do you call it, extended data, right? So we have to actually query for it. I mean, the stupid way would be to just create, say, comments list, which is boring. But I guess there's the, I mean, yeah, okay, why not? Let's create a comment list. So we're gonna have a view that has, first of all, this date, right? But I'm gonna do this state constructed, say post title. Are you complaining? What is, wow, one component per file. Yeah, okay. Okay then. Like, oh, I guess it's not updated again. Code. Triggers. Okay, can I just use the props? But no, we cannot really use the props, right? So it has to be component, or maybe component update. Then it's going to be basically this props. So it should be this props, right? Because it already is updated. New props. Why? Is it always unmounted? Is that how it works? Component did mount it. Oh shit, I closed the app. Start it back. Okay. And that also doesn't work. Interesting. I'm curious. God damn it, I'm an idiot. I should do that. And then we can actually just say, oh man, I'm so dumb. Okay. Sometimes happens. So props navigation constructor, and this is going to be state, right? Yeah, okay, you know what, this annoys me to no end, so I'm gonna react no multicomp. I'm gonna say that three comp off to you. I don't care about that right now. There we go, much nicer. Okay, so theoretically, right, so we get the post. It's now in a constructor and it's now assigned as a post. why it has a root. What? Oh, it's params. Okay, so not the state itself, it's state params. There. Now works, yay. Okay, so cool. So now we can have this, so we can style font size 4, font weight alt. This and nine center, right? So we get the nice centered header. Then we can, you know what? We can have a. Is there a web? I mean, there should be a web view component, right? Just web view. There we go. We can put a web view in the middle. This is a thing that you probably should not do, but we're gonna do it anyway. So we're gonna show the inline article, because why the hell not? Gonna be post well. Have to import the web view from the components, right? There you go. So you can actually read that stuff here. And then we're gonna split it. So we're gonna say, well, god damn it, I'll close the emulator again. So we are gonna split it and we're gonna say that web view is style. We already have style here. So this is going to be flex one, and then we're going to have list view. Going to be flex, no, style flex one. So theoretically, we now should have a list view and a web view split. Right, okay, so I screwed up the, so it needs data provider. So basically the idea is to provide the comments below it, which would probably never work in a mobile situation because, you know, you don't really want to split the view like this because it's just not very comfortable, but you know, what the hell, we can do that here. Okay, this, and in this case, this actually our row thing is not exactly correct because we need to compare IDs. There we go. And I guess here we're going to compare IDs as well because comparing objects like this doesn't really work. What do you not like here again? New state comment. There we go. And list view. Done. So we're going to do this. This statement for now is just gonna be text and gonna be as whatever. So theory, there you go. Okay, so now we have a list view with comments here, the article itself here, and now we just need to load the comments, right? So load comments. You know what, to do it actually in a better way, we could just move that out into a function called load articles. Do this because theoretically we don't care if it's mounted or not, it's just going to load the articles and set them to the state, right? Okay, so we're gonna load comments, and to do that I am gonna be lazy and I'm just gonna copy that. So comments await fetch base URL, right? Slash, how do we get the comments from there? Users comment. No, this is, or does it provide the comments right away? Kids, I guess kids are, so kids, the idea of comments. Okay, so this is what we want. Okay, so we don't actually, no, we do need, so we need a comments here. Comments, wait, promise all, this state post screwed up so much. kids map ID to fetch item ID JSON, right? So it's going to be the same. And then just basically the comment format is different. Say comments, comments, and then basically once we render it is going to be C text, right? Oops, theoretically update, yes. Hey, okay, so the text there is actually HTML by the looks of it. Okay, React Native text HTML. Can you render? Can I just render HTML? HTML view, HTML text, text, number of lines, style, props. Doesn't look like it support allow font scaling, suppress highlighting, nested text, containers. Yeah. Okay, so I guess it doesn't support. There is this HTML view, but I mean, they say just HTML view. I guess I can just. Okay, so they use the custom element here. What do? They actually looks like they translate the whole text into React Native element. Okay, this is insane. Why not? Let's use that. Somebody already did that. I don't see any problems with it. Yarn adds HTML. Import HTML. Okay. There we go. Now, for comments, we say. Is it just? I just put in this stuff. Oh, okay, value and then. This the value the text, okay. Yarn start, and in theory we should see a nicer comments, and I guess that would be a nice place to wrap it up. So I'm gonna think what kind of stuff do I want to talk about in the video. I guess beyond just using the elements and building basic stuff, the interesting topic would be the native bits, because one of the strength, what do you not like? Undefined is not an object. This state post, okay, so it might not have kids. That is absolutely true. I'm gonna be lazy and gonna do that. Okay, we have comments without authors, but they are actually proper HTML. I mean, obviously you could go ahead and make it nicer, you know, the at least the same look as here, for example, but whatever. We built a simple Hacker News app that actually shows you the article and comments in line. It's good enough. Okay, so yeah, as I said, one of the strengths of React Native is actually doing native modules. The downside is, of course, that you can only do native module for one of the things, right? For either for Android or for iOS, and you will have to do them in the language that is specific to that platform. So for Android you will have to write Java, for iOS you will have to write Swift, C, C++, Objective-C, you know, whatever you like. I think Swift is the nicer one. I haven't actually tried it myself personally yet, but yeah, we can give it a shot. So essentially it comes down to writing JavaScript wrapper and importer around it, right? I've written the Android modules, native modules that were used within React Native, and it wasn't hard. It was relatively simple. So yeah. But okay, I think that's a good spot to stop. I'm gonna kill all of that. I'm gonna just clean up here a bit. Feel free to ask your questions if you have any. If not, well then thank you for staying during this live stream with me. I will publish it to YouTube under live streams, new live stream section, I guess, where all the stuff is gonna be. And yeah, let's see how that turns out. All right, guess that will be it. Thank you for watching, and as usual, I see you next time. Bye.